People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now, just as promised, today I'm going to talk about the Rioting King situation. But there's also another case that has to be added to it at the last minute, because you've now heard that SSP Clunis has passed away. This is incredible, so I'm going to have to talk about this as well. But before I go any further, people, let me just put this out here. And before my subs, my loyal supporters, start say, boy, Serpy, you can't do that. People, I've had to put a lot of thought into this. So this is going to be the last video I make until I actually reach on the other side and get settled. So you won't hear another video from me until some point next week, right? Because as I said in the video yesterday, I will take Wi-Fi abroad, right? So once that's done, settled in, right, people, that's when you hear another video from me. So look out for another video at some point next week. I can't give you the exact date because, you know, them things are very hectic, right? But what needs to be done has to be done, right? Now, another thing. People, how do you want me to deal with these agents? When I tell you that they're agents operating against interests of Jamaica, when I tell you that they're criminals who have disguised themselves, right, as whatever, entertainers, bloggers, whatever, how do you want me to deal with them? Because you see, I've actually found out that one of them is actually a corrupt police officer who was charged in 2013 for armed robbery. And this person is one of the people them who got the hardest on YouTube against me. Now, any sane person would ask themselves, why would anybody be trying to go so hard for this try, Sir P? Why would anybody who really means Jamaica so good, why would they be trying to destroy Sir P? That's because they're criminals and they're agents. You don't believe me? Look at your screen right now. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm asking you, my subscribers and my viewers, my listeners, do you want me to expose? And I'm not talking about their gimmicks expose. I'm talking about actual expose. I'm talking about pictures, court details, when they went to Horizon, real name, etc. Do you want me to demonstrate to not just this agent, but to the others operating on YouTube, just how fast I can gather intelligence on them, even if they change their name? You see the first three letters you're seeing that I've left? KIP. Those are the first three letters of a name of a YouTuber that have you been following for years. And you don't know that YouTuber was an ex-cop, a corrupt cop, somebody I actually know. Jamaica is a very, very small world. And I'm thinking, maybe I need to make this person famous. But if my subscribers say, Sir P, Gima Bly, I think about it. But if them therapy do it, then guess whose YouTube career is going to go in a tailspin? Guess who's going to know what it actually means to be exposed, seeing that's what they're trying to do to me as a proxy? And then maybe that will teach you others out there who are even easier to get to, because this person doesn't show his face, has a fake name, and it took me less than 5 minutes to get his file. People, it's up to you. The ball is in your court. Now let's move on to Rioting King. Now this case is a textbook example as to why artists really need to leave out certain company. I don't know what it is, right? When a man finally utilize him talent and he can escape certain lifestyle, him end up cling to it even more. People, Moby is very, very divided. I already tell him about flankers and the good and what so, right? We have many other crews and gangs in Moby, right? You have 5150, you have Dunst, Tugs, all kind of people. These organizations are serious, right? And to be honest, as I said before, even though Stone Crusher itself gone, Now for these organizations, you know, they're basically the offspring of Stonecrusher, right? Just like how Stonecrusher was the offspring of Renegade, Stonecrusher now has offsprings, right? And them and they around the place is red. See, from what I'm gathering, Raging King was targeted according to Batman logic. I'll tell you what I mean. It wasn't necessarily that Raging King hit out there and shoot at the place and then somebody see him and shoot him back. No. You have to understand, once you come from a certain place, once you sing song and talk about certain things, once you par with certain man, the other stem and them look upon that as you are involved. Then the business if you don't have a rifle and shoot other people. You are involved according to Batman law. And if the man then catch up on the road, guess what? Things can get very, very tricky. Trickier, I come in back. One of the car them, it's a little miss up, pull over, Raging King realize the car now follow him, turn back. And they on the road, Malinga. Them get spot. From what I gather, it wasn't a targeted ops. I mean, somebody just spot them. Because there was another funeral going on close by. And the people them who were going to that funeral, a passed and spot Raging King. One phone call make, and that's all it took. 87 turn up, and you know 87 can shoot already. You know 87 can shoot already. Because a young lady end up losing her life. Her name is Sasha Lee Blackwood, 28-year-old customer service rep. People, that young woman had two children. They are now motherless. And for what? For what? Just like that. Just like that, it don't cost nothing at all. Life don't cost nothing at all in a movie. And then, we hear into Raging King pick up around very close to his spine. So, even if he pulled through, he might be in for a very, very long recovery. And another individual also got injured. See, these cases are frustrating. They're frustrating because they can be avoided. They can be avoided. When you notice, at the same time, the artists them get caught up in a foolishness. Remember, people love telling us, oh, are those words? Words don't mean nothing. But only realize that the man they may push certain words and certain energy, these things keep happening to. Now, at least Raging King still have breath flowing through his body, right? But Sasha Lee Blackwood, she's gone. She's gone, and I'm pitting them now on the matter right now. And you know what? To be honest, I'm worried for what's going to happen afterwards. Because trust me, there is going to be retaliation. There is going to be retaliation. These gangs that I'm be, these organizations, these crews, and I saw them deal for them thing. They don't take something like this and forgive and forget. Whether it want to be Dunstogs or 5150 or 1452, whoever it might be, whether it want to be any of the flankers, man, them Sparta, listen, there's going to be retaliation. And this put the risk that somebody else are going to happen for them on the scene and end up losing life. People, did you not watch the video? Did you not watch the video? There were children there. There were children on the scene. And the 87 Octane who pulled up, he didn't care. He didn't care. These are the criminals who operate in Jamaica. Suppose one of them pitily, they end up getting shot. Because there already no 87 is going to shoot. Pure wild shot. Just like that, a child would have lost their life. And people in Jamaica see them things here and see how careless the man them treat human life. Right? And instead of trying to expose them man they, instead of trying to shame them man they, them rather shame Sir P. I'm telling you about these agents. Imagine if they were to dedicate their time and resources to sinking some of these gangs. Jamaica would be a better place. People, we need to do better. We need to do better. This is St. James we are talking about. St. James, which was once the place where people go and say, listen, I go left town, go to St. James, go try and make a better life. Better life? St. James have all this money. Moby have all this money. Scammer money have flood St. James. Drugs money flood St. James. And yet still, the funeral homes them down there are making massive profits. You think everybody would be happy? You think say, the bag of money will run through the place? Would I make the place peaceful because, remember, and money are the problem, right? Well, that theory is clearly debunked. I told you. Culture and mindset. Maybe a youth them, the first million they make, them go buy a gun. When a scammer get rich, the first thing him do, bring in 2-3 rifle. That's culture and mindset. Not for these youths, not for these scammers in Mobi, they make more money than legit business people in Jamaica. They cannot only turn around their lives, they can turn around the lives of their communities. But they're not interested in that. The way they want to be done, the way they want to run out of place, one man of all 20 rifle. One man in a Mobi of all 20 rifle. Ask the people down there if they don't believe me. This is insane. The artists, they need to make up their mind where them depend. It's either you want to be a musician, and you want to practice your craft, right? And you want to tour the world and have fun and entertain people, or you want to depend on the ends and mix up in a badness. You see, the moment when you try to play both, things get sticky. Because even though you now bust a gun yourself, the man then just want to see you beside a smaddy. The man just want to see you a parish smaddy. The man just want to see you a call smaddy name. And they're like, oh, him in it too. That's bad man law. That's bad man logic. Rising King, hope you pull through. And when you come back around, you can walk and talk and function properly. Right? You're young and you have a whole heap of life left in you. Right? But hopefully, the rest of man them can learn from this. But that's wishful thinking. It probably won't happen. Right, so people, let me just finish off with SSP Clueness. This is very spooky. This is very spooky. SSP Clueness has passed away, about 18 days after him first get shot up? Because everything I've heard was saying that SSP Clueness was coming around and he was starting to feel good. And he was starting to feel back to his old self and he was getting ready to leave. I'm actually hearing that the day he passed away is the day he was supposed to leave the hospital. Right away, I'm going to tell you what the Jamaican people are going to say. The Jamaican people are going to say something sinister happened here. They're not going to accept that SSP Clueness just so happened to pass away 18 days after first getting shot up. When, before he could even talk on the interviews, because remember, Clueness did an interview shortly afterwards, right? And he was talking, even though he was saying some things, as I was saying in my video, you know, really sound like him 100 still, but he was talking, right? And the report said that he was coming around and it seemed like he was about to discharge. And now he's gone. So everybody was messaging me saying, Sir P, this looks spooky. This looks spooky. I mean, feel like them doing this and them doing that. Feel like them put this name drip. People are putting out all kind of theories. That is what's going to happen. As for me, I don't know anything possible, but I'm sure his family is going to do an autopsy, right? An independent autopsy, and then they can see what the SSP Clueness or what actually made him pass away, because I don't know. I was very surprised. I'm not even going to pretend like said, because I see it coming. I was very surprised. Matter of fact, when people first started messaging me and telling me that SSP Clueness had passed away, I said, no man, maybe when I get it wrong, look how long Clueness is in the hospital. He was in there so long I was starting to wonder if he'd get discharged, but he just never released the information. But boy, it really, really spooky. Really spooky, people. I'm going to say, tomorrow, the rest of the week, all I go hear are conspiracy theories, because enough people just now can't stomach this one, right? It already looked like there was some kind of cover-up going on. So when people hear something like this, they're like, see, that may I tell you, see them get rid of Clueness there. That might not be the case. It might be a case where he just had some kind of complication, or who knows, he was very stressed out or something. But as I said, I'm sure the family is going to do an autopsy and then they can get some answers, and hopefully the Jamaican people can also get some answers, because even though I know Clueness is for them family, based on the fact that the way how he lost his life, I think the public have an interest in what happened here, because it would be really, really unfortunate if it turned out to there's a more sinister side to this, right? So Clueness, being a senior officer, being a public servant who lost his life in the line of duty, I think the public, the people, they want to know what go on, right? They want to know what go on, and it would at least quiet down some of the rumors them who are going to naturally start to run on board the place, Right, so there you go, people. As I said, this will be the last video until sometime next week. Until then, everybody, stay safe. Take care of yourself. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.